Hello, Mark Sutt with HurricaneTrack.com here. I want to talk about Hurricane Jose for just a moment. Nothing urgent or breaking news or anything like that, but just something interesting that I read in the forecast discussion that I want to share with you. First of all, the stats. 80-mile-per-hour winds now moving to the northwest at 9 miles per hour. This is the latest forecast tracked, and if we look at it just for what it is, the center position here would stay off of the east coast of the United States, but as we are going to look at in the forecast discussion, the hurricane is going to grow in size and strength, and so it's going to affect a large area. So even up here, it would be a very large tropical storm, probably with a huge wind field, and that needs to be addressed. So let's go back and read the forecast discussion on this system, and I can explain with the map what's happening. All right, so the first paragraph is all about the structure, etc., and the intensity of it. The second paragraph, this is the one that I really want to show you and point some things out from. All right, so we start out that Jose continues to move towards the northwest, and the initial motion estimate is 305 degrees at 8 knots. The main source of uncertainty in the track forecast is at days 4 and 5. See, that's a huge clue right there. Since the global models disagree on the speed at which Jose will move northward along the western edge of the subtropical ridge. So I can show you what that looks like right here. You can see the subtropical ridge outlined out here. This is the big old Bermuda High. And it's a matter of how fast does this go up and around that ridge before some energy up here somewhere comes down and tries to pick it up. So let's just keep reading and I'll explain that further. The GFS continues to show a faster movement, so that's a clue, which allows Jose to pass very close to the U.S. East Coast before an approaching trough forces the cyclone to turn more towards the northeast. On the other hand, the ECMWF, or what we call the Euro, shows a slower track, so the trough steers the hurricane farther east. In other words, the longer Jose takes to move off the east coast, you know, to where it's in a position so it's just east of the U.S. east coast, this trough is going to be coming in, this approaching trough right here that gets mentioned, and it's a matter of speed. It's just like trying to go catch the bus. If you are quick enough and you can get to the bus stop, the bus, will, in this case, I guess it's kind of the opposite. The slower it goes, then that's interesting, so my analogy isn't going to work. And I could just start this recording over to correct it, but I'm not, because I try to learn from these things. So in this case, the faster Jose goes, then the trough comes in too late. And it's like running out in front of traffic, and then you get run over later, I guess, is the way to look at it. And so the faster it goes, the farther north it will be before it turns east. That's the way to look at this. The slower it goes, then it gives time for that trough to catch up to it. So that's very interesting. I'm glad I caught myself in that analogy, which would have been incorrect. I was going to say that, you know, if you get there in time, you catch the bus. But that's often what we see. When they turn north, it's a matter of does it turn north and reach the trough in time like a magnet or somebody trying to catch a bus or a cab or whatever, or the bus leaves it behind. How many times have we seen that where something leaves a hurricane behind? In this case, it's the opposite. It's how fast does it move up the coast before the trough comes in to sweep it out. So they say the NHC forecast has not been changed substantially and is still just a touch slower than the model consensus out of respect to the Euro. And then this right here is just huge. When the 0Z, Euro, and UKMET models, that's the UK Met, become available tonight, it could shed more light on the future speed of the hurricane. Isn't that interesting? It's all about the speed now. It is still important to note that the average track errors at days 4 and 5 are, you know, up to 225 miles, and the error this time around could be in the speed of the hurricane along its track. Isn't that interesting? So when they're saying it could be here, it really could be here, or it could be here. So it's the speed along the track that's going to be the deal this time. And then right here, while the official forecast track keeps the center of Jose offshore for the next few days, all of the global models show the hurricane becoming rather large by late this weekend as it moves to the east of North Carolina. So for that reason, a tropical storm watch may be required or needed for a portion of the Carolina coast tomorrow. So what does this look like? Let's look at the 18Z model, the GFS here. There's your ridge of high pressure out here over the Atlantic. There's Jose moving around the backside of it. And you can see in this situation, you know, it's hard to tell because we're not comparing it to other models superimposed at the same time, but it moves fast enough in the model here so that Jose crosses southern New England here. Watch as this happens. You're going to see it's going to go right over that blue line that I drew, and so it gets up there before this energy is able to come down and grab it. All right, and that energy is like right in here. Watch right at the end. You see that energy start to come in right here towards the end of the five-day forecast period. Wait for it. Wait for it. There it comes right there. Just a tiny piece of energy, though. That's it right there. So let's just go to the end because this is fascinating stuff because we can actually see what they're talking about. There's the trough energy right there, and Jose gets up there fast enough so that this is already kind of going by, okay? And Jose is able to come up around, and as the energy goes by, then everything goes with it. Instead of if it waits later to come up, and then that energy digs in, is able to kick it out as the whole pattern changes. But it's interesting because this is just a little bit of energy here. This is not some deep longitudinal trough. And then look what's happening back here. You've got heights building again. So, you know, this wavy pattern here is very progressive. So it's complicated. That's for darn sure. And then look down there. Whatever, Lee or Maria, whichever one develops first, and we really need to keep an eye on that. I'll talk about that more in the morning. So there it is on Jose, and a look at the discussion from the Hurricane Center. It's the speed. It's the speed. We'll have to watch the speed, all right? So that's it. I'm going to try to get some sleep. You should do the same. Don't stay up watching the UKMET, the GFS, and the Euro. Get yourself some sleep for the weekend. All the model data will be out in the morning, all right? I promise. I'm Mark Seth for HurricaneTrack.com. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll have another update for you early in the morning.